rivalry game in the NFC North. Granted, this is the lower rung of the division. Kind of weird to say that, especially with the Bears coming off a division title and coming off the NFC Championship appearance, and then of course the Vikes the year before were in the NFC Championship. But these are the two worst teams in the division. It is in Chicago. It's on Sunday Night Football. I don't know who at NBC thought this would be a good game even before the season started. But it's the game, so I'm going to watch it along with a lot of other people. There's no Antoine Winfield in this game for the Vikings, but that is okay because the Bears have one of the worst receiving corps in the league. They have the worst offensive line in the league. The Vikings will be able to key on the run, stack the box, and their safeties have been playing pretty well in shallow coverage, which, if you're playing the Bears, I guess everything is shallow coverage because Cutler's getting rushed right as he snaps the ball. So can't really go deep anyway with those fast receivers. Hussein Abdullah, Jamarcus Sanford and Tyrell Johnson and company. They're playing well enough where you can't blame them for the team's shortcomings this season. Now, obviously, I'll get to why they could lose this game, Donovan McNabb, but the Bears' defense is ranked near the bottom in a lot of important and key categories, including run defense. Surprisingly, they're giving up 5.7 yards a carry. The monsters up in way. Are you kidding me? And the Vikings have Adrian Peterson. Their offensive line is blocking well, which is a surprise to some people, with Herrera coming off of a serious injury and some people thinking Steve Hutchinson is on the downturn and about to end his career, call it quits, because he ain't got it no more, but apparently he's got something. They did a great job against Arizona. Granted, I know Arizona's not been great against late, but they ran okay against the Chargers. They ran when they wanted to against the Bucks and the Lions. Peterson did not get the touches that he should have gotten, and a guy of his quality should have gotten. And he did last week. He got 29 carries, 3 touchdowns. And speaking of McNabb, Donovan McNabb, he's not gonna have to throw the ball that much in this game. Last week, he only threw the ball 21 times. Kevin Cobb, who McNabb beat again, 2-0 against Kevin Cobb, for those keeping score. Kevin Cobb had 21 completions. McNabb had 21 attempts. Adrian Peterson ran the ball 29 times. And the Vikings, as a team, not counting Donovan McNabb, had 12 more rushes than McNabb had passing attempts. And they blew the roof off of the Metrodome. I guess the second time that's happened in the last year. Bad joke. Anyways, they will be able to do what is very hard, I guess at times rare, for an NFL team to do and successfully do, is run the ball 40 plus times and only throw about 15 times. Julius Peppers out for this game. Matsuina out for this game. Two of the better defensive linemen, and obviously Peppers is arguably the best defensive player. You have an aging Anthony Adams at defensive tackle, along with a soft Amobi Okoye, who is, of course, a bust, was drafted very high in the first round by Houston Texans a couple years back. So, Adrian Peterson, have fun Sunday night. Another great game for you against the Bears, I guess. The only thing to say about that would be just don't fumble the ball. Yeah. So, I'm going to take the Vikings in an upset, small upset I guess, but in an upset on the road, 16-7, and the key matchup in this game, Israel Adonijé, defensive end for the Bears, against Charlie Johnson and Phil Lodeful, the tackles for the Vikes. And to add on to that, Henry Melton, who's been one of the nice surprises, former running back of the Texas Longhorns, as athletic as can be. He's moving to defensive end in this game for the Bears because of Pepper's injury, which may take away from his pass rushing ability inside. See how much he switches over back to his, I guess now you can say, natural position of interior lineman. But he's going to be starting in one of the defensive end spots opposite Israel Adonijé. So there you go. 16-7 Minnesota Vikings in a rivalry game.